In this video, I'll show you how to remove objects in Photoshop. Now, the good thing with Photoshop is there's no one way of doing things. There's a few different tools you can use and I'll demonstrate some basic ones. So yeah, let's get started. So here's a picture. Let's say I want to remove myself. The easiest way to do is select myself. And once I have the selection, I'll go into Edit, Fill, and from here, Content Aware, Normal 100%, and click OK. And as you guys could see, Photoshop will do the rest for you. And now I'll go back and show you another way of removing the same object. For this example, I'm going to use the Spot Healing tool, and I'm just going to select over what I want to remove. And Photoshop does the rest for me. Now let's look at another picture. Let's say I want to remove this pole right here and I decided to go with the Spot Healing tool. All I'm going to do is select over what I want to remove. And you'll see Photoshop does the rest for me. And for most part, it did a pretty good job. For any imperfections, I can go back and manually fix them. Now depending on the situation, you might not be able to use every tool to get the effect you're looking for. So just play around until you find something that works for you. And slowly you'll be better able to judge for the right tool. Now another tool you can use is the clone stamp tool. And let's say I want to remove this pole right here. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and I'm going to select an area that I want to replicate. And I'm going to press option. And I'm going to sample that area. And now I'm just going to fill it in over here. And I'm just going to sample it from a few different areas just to blend things in. And I usually try to keep my softness as low as I can and it will blend everything in pretty good. Alright, so here's another situation. Let's say I want to remove this pole right here, but for some reason I don't want to go anything above the concrete. And if I try to remove it like that, you'll see it kind of messes up at the corners. So the way to fix that is, we're gonna make a selection. And now once we have our selection, whatever I do, that will only imply within the selection. And I'll show you guys how that works. So I sampled this area. And you'll see the corners are done just within the area I selected. And I'm gonna use this technique a little bit more in our next picture and you'll see how it works. So let's look at another picture. Here's something a little more complicated. Let's say I want to remove myself, the person in the back, some of the buildings. Now you'll see if I try to use the Spot Healing tool or the Content Aware tool, it won't really do the job. So in a situation like this, you'll need to manually work around, try to fill in things using a clone tool. Now for the rock, I made an outline and cloned the other side. And then I used the Spot Healing tool to blend it all in. And then I cloned both sides of the grass, mixing it all in using the clone tool. For most part, I'm using a smooth brush, it just works better blending things in. After that, I selected the other rock and cloned it once again. I decided to get rid of the black rock just because it would have needed more time getting it right and the picture looks just fine without it. At this point, I decided to switch back to Spot Healing tool, just wanted to see what the software can do, playing around with size and hardness. And for most part, it got rid of what I wanted, but it did make things a little unaligned. So to fix that, I'm going to use the clone stamp tool. And for a little more detail, I made a selection and used the paint tool to blend things in. And all looks good, I'm just going to blend in the concrete using the Spot Healing tool once again. Next up, I'm going to remove this guy, and all this can be done using the Spot Healing tool. So I just made a selection of what I wanted to remove and Photoshop does the rest for me. And again, for a little imperfection, I could use the Spot Healing tool once again to remove things manually. Alright, so we're almost done. For removing the buildings, I'm going to use the Spot Healing tool, just playing around with size and hardness to find a good sweet spot. I'm doing this very rough, but you can spend as much time as you need to get it as precise as you want. But I'm not going to focus on the background too much, just because for most imperfections, it's barely visible. And yeah, after playing around a little bit, here's the end result. So we started from this to this, and it looks pretty good. If you like this video and want to see more videos like this, let me know in a comment below and feel free to share this one.